fans. Day 3, Hot Rod Texas Tour, heading out to Gateway Classic Cars. That is the meet spot for this morning before we head out to Temple, Texas for the heading to the Little River Dragway, old school drag strip. But this Gateway Classic Cars, that'll be a cool meet spot. I'm going to try to get some good footage for you guys. I think we got about 150 mile or so run today, so hopefully we'll have a good day. Check back with you here soon. Here we are inside of Gateway Classic Cars here in New Braunfels. Pretty nice selection of cars here, all for sale. '50s style rod right here with the moon caps, chop top. Very cool. A 1958 Jeep. Mustang Row right here. Clean old 86. Yeah. very clean.
Factory air. And power steering. 65 fastback. Very nice car. Clean 59. '67 Camaro, straight six. And finally a Buick. It's the only Buick Regal I have seen on this entire trip besides mine. An old Porsche 929. Z28. 4:42. And this is what would have been a clean GTO, except for they ruined it with the LS swap. Very clean Cougar. Four-speed car, very cool. Cornet RT, a very odd color, very serious looking Firebird. Still Pontiac power, that's good. Let's put some slicks on there. Pretty nasty street strip car right here. Super. I know we got a lot of fans of those. Some Bogarts on it. It's probably a street strip car. A little bit of everything here at Gateway Classic Cars, that's for sure.
Some of these look brand
new. Like that Jeep over there, right? Skyline, right hand drive, as expected. Thank you. go see what we got outside. Show you what we got going on outside. It's all the cars on the cruise.
It's pretty built. It's awesome. And I got like a 2x2. It's drivable. You know what I mean? And it's not super aggressive.
Again, this is day 3, Hot Rod Tour of Texas. This is the meat spot at Gateway Classic Cars.
Looking.
Badass old blazer. That thing is beautiful. Wow.
What are y'all at
there? I can't really see in there.
Tornado?
You heard that?
Yeah.
We're 30 minutes north of Victoria on
okay.
Alright.
I've been staying there before. I was thinking.
Oh, yeah. Someone between you from Victoria, you go right here.
Oh, my God. They're so love it.
You bet.
I do not.
Had a lot of sleep.
It's got a t-shirt with it.
Ah, for real. I got a tag up there. So you have to go to your and throw it to the Houston. They came up.
Badass looking old Ford truck. Parking lot's completely full and a line down the street. Thank you. pretty good turnout today, considering how bad the weather was last night. Everybody went into hiding, seemed like. But everybody's getting them cleaned back up. I took the Grand National to the car wash at 5 o'clock this morning, about 5 miles from the hotel, and gave it a bath, which it severely needed.
Yeah, they were telling us about that car
getting stuck in the
water. Gonna be a good cruise today. Let's go get a good group of cars.
It's pretty good.
Definitely a few different cars from the ones that we've seen at the other meets.
Signature.
No kidding.
Well, get me out of your way, sir.
Yeah, this car is cool.
Yeah, unbelievably cool.
Hemi in the value.
Put that Hemi in there. I mean, that's
don't see those.
And then the line is all the way down the street.
We'll be right back.
Welcome back, guys. We're here at Little River Dragway in Temple, Texas. And this is a small, old school, backwoods drag strip. Try to get you guys some footage of some of this. Mile track, probably at least 40 years old. Very sketchy. Looks like fun though. This is the Hot Rod Tour of Texas crew that have pulled in, but they're also doing a Saturday night test and tune. So a lot of the race cars here are not part of the Texas group, or the Texas Tour group. They're just here testing and tuning. Some fast cars here though. Looks like some probably few bottom 5 second cars, maybe some of them faster than that. Once they get up and running, I'll try to get some passes for you. Seen this car earlier. Stick shift car. Very cool old drag strip. Old backwoods drag strip. Thank you. sketchy truck. Can't believe 5 second cars are running through here. Good morning, YouTube fans. Welcome back to the AJ Speed Shop YouTube channel. Coming to you today from day 4 of the Hot Rod Texas Tour in the hotel here in Temple, Texas. And what would a classic car road trip be without some sort of turmoil? So I'm about 500, 600 miles in at this point. And it seems like the Grand National has developed some sort of turbo noise. I don't know if I've got a compressor wheels hitting the housing or a bearing or something's going out, but the turbo sounds funny to me. So I'm headed out to the parking lot right now, and I'm going to pull the inlet piping off, inspect the compressor wheel, make sure it's not hitting the compressor housing, and just check for any other obvious signs before I continue to move on. It's about 6 o'clock right now. I'm gonna get out there and get this thing pulled apart, check it out. Hopefully back together before the group starts to leave so we can try to ride along. So let's go see what kind of surprise we have waiting for us this morning. All right, guys, got the turbo inlet piping off. I don't see any obvious signs of contact on the turbo, so that's good. Let's see if I can figure out if it's got any excessive in play on the shaft here. Spins good. Oh yeah, turbo's tight. It has no in play, so no contact, no in play. Spins over really good. So it at least seems that our noise is not our turbo at least grinding itself to death here and shooting metal all through the motor. So that's a good sign. Yeah, nope, this sucker looks good. Okay, moving on. I guess I'll start checking all the couplers and everything else that might have anything to do. I didn't see anything obvious, any couplers obviously off. Blow valve hose is still on. Don't know. It's definitely making a weird noise though. Somewhere. I'll keep hunting. All right, guys. So I see no obvious signs of turbo death. All my couplers are in place. Nothing has any holes in it, so I'm not sure what the source of that weird turbo noise was I heard last night, but I guess I will revisit it when I get home. I'm gonna go ahead and leave the turbo heat shield off. I did notice that my turbo drain hose gasket, it's kind of going to be hard to tell from here, but the gasket is getting, had a leak on it on the bottom of the turbo. Looked like the gasket started pushing out, so I snugged that up a little bit. Made a pretty good little mess down under the bottom of the car. So hopefully that will make it home, because I know no one's going to have those gaskets in stock anywhere. Plus it's a pain to change it, so I think I'm going to go ahead and cut off this last leg of the tour. It's about another, I think, 80 miles to the next stop, but it's 80 miles further away from home. So I think I'm gonna go ahead and take these signs and pack everything up and head on back towards the house. Quit while I'm ahead, just in case this turbo starts acting up or this drain starts leaking. So we will see. I want to get ready to check out of here and get back on the road. I'll check back with you guys later. Keep your fingers crossed. Well, guys, I'm making a run for the hills. I'm gonna go ahead and take this sucker home. Can't find anything obviously wrong with it. Seems like it's running okay, but the turbo definitely has a different tone to it. I don't know, didn't find any loose couplers or any blown off couplers or anything like that. I'm kind of suspect that maybe the blow off valve, maybe an O-ring or something has broken the blow off valve and I got air bypassing through the blow off valve or something. I'm not sure exactly, but I'm going to go ahead and head on back to the house. I got about 180 miles or so, I think. It's about roughly 3 hours, so I'm just going to cruise on back and start investigating stuff when I get home. Assuming we make it. So I will check back with you guys when we get back.